we are Tribal Soup Project. Welcome to another episode of Rhythm Soup. Today we're going to be going over the proper technique for the Doumbek.
The Doumbek is in the goblet drum family, as you can tell. It's normally played on your non-dominant leg, up on your hip. So if you're right-handed like I am, the drum would be placed on your left leg. If you were left-handed, you'd place it on your right leg.
Unless you're totally weird like I am and I'm left-handed and play Doumbek and friend drum right-handed.
Now in addition, you can play it with your leg kind of up, like your heel is off the ground, locking it in place. Or some people feel comfortable playing it more with it in their lap, where it's kind of between both your legs a little bit. And again, it's really more of a comfort thing than anything else, so it's really whatever you're comfortable with. Today, I'm going to play it this way, and you should try both ways to see how each one works. So the first sound we're going to make with the Doumbek is going to be called a doom, also referred to as a bass, depending upon which drum speak you want to use. And the doom, again, is played in the upper quarter of the piece of pie, so to speak. And when you hit the drum, you're hitting it with your flat hand with your fingers closed. And it's kind of like if you touch something hot, you take your hand up, you pop it off. So it should have a nice bassy ring to it. And again, your fingers are closed. The next sound that you can make on the Doumbek is going to be a tek, or a dominant tone. And that's made mostly with the ring finger. The other fingers strike the drums with your fingers open, but more as a support for that finger, because that finger is literally hitting just the very edge of the drum where the sound is the highest and the clearest. And you'd be hitting it and sticking. Find the proper placement for the size shell that you have to get a nice clear sound. Now to get some practice in, what we're going to do now is we're going to go from the bass or the doom to the tek and just go back and forth. So it would be boom, tek, boom, tek, boom, tek, sound that you can make on the Doumbek is called the ka. This would be the non-dominant tone, and it's played with your left hand, which should be sitting at about exactly 12 o'clock on your drum. Now, there's a couple of different ways you can do the ka. In the beginning, a lot of people start out with keeping their hand on the drum and just moving their fingers, and that's a okay way to start because that allows you to make that sound the easiest right away. The problem that you'll face is that you're using a muscle group that you're not used to using, and this will quickly go away while you're playing, and it'll sound more like this. The proper way to do a ka, and it's going to sound a little funny, is you want to put your thumb and your index finger together with your other three fingers sticking up like that, and it is commonly referred to as the duck. Now you take this, and you lay this on that same 12 o'clock position, and you find your hand is angled slightly now. It shouldn't be uncomfortable, and again, you're not going to be moving your fingers so much as just basically picking your hand up and letting it come down. The meat of your hand is striking the rim of the drum on the side, causing your fingers to catapult forwards, striking the drum in the proper place, pretty much all the time. And that'll be the quickest way to developing a good ka. And a ka is a sound that can be difficult to produce successfully. So that's something you'll have to work on. If it's not there, it'll come. And you'll remember that day for the rest of your life. I remember when I found my ka, exactly.
I haven't found my ka yet, so I'm sure when I find it, God, I'm going to have a bargain.
And you may sit there and go, what is he talking about? Trust me, you will remember the day you find your God. So, But let's go ahead and practice that drill now using the doom, the tech, and the ka, or the bass, tone, tone. And we'll go like this. Practice your ka and really try and move forward on that quickly. An easy way to do that is to play that same drill, but we'll be doing a double ka. So it would go doom tek ka ka, doom tek ka ka, and it'll go like this. Another sound that you can make on the Doumbek is commonly referred to as a pop. And you'll often hear that in a lot of rhythms when people are playing to, as a really sharp accented note. Now, the pop is often difficult, even more difficult than the ka to get. And what you're ending up doing is you're kind of cupping your hand a little bit so that you make this plane so you have like a little pocket. It's kind of hard to see. But you make this little pocket, and when you strike the drum, you're basically kind of just cupping it at that right moment. And again, it takes a lot of practice, and don't be discouraged if it's not something that comes to you quickly. It doesn't to a lot of people. It takes a long time. And it sounds something like this. To get a clear pop, again, it's really all about shaping of the hand to where you're just capturing that air right at the top of the drum. It takes practice. Again, don't be discouraged. Another thing that you can do that is also referred to kind of like a grab or a slap is by grabbing the drum kind of like with all your fingertips, kind of like you palm like a basketball or something, and you hit those all at the same time. That makes a sound like this. These sounds can all be utilized in any of the places on most rhythms where the tone is taking place or the ka is taking place. So you can substitute these pretty much verbatim. Some other things that you can do, so you can roll your fingers, which is a little bit difficult. But if someone's used to doing this on their desk at work or something like that, this will come easy. There's left hand technique that I'm still working on myself. And there's just a lot of things that you can do. One thing that's also a good practice is some of the drill techniques that they have with the snare drummers. And the most simple one that they play all the time is called a paradiddle, which goes right, left, right.
We hope that you guys learned something and enjoyed watching as well. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave a message down below.
And that subscribe thing, you should probably click on that so that you know when we're putting some new stuff out for you.
Also hit the like button, visit our website, check out some of our other stuff.
Twitter, Instagram, whatever, Facebook, come find us.
And until next time guys, happy drumming. Bye.